Boxing superstar Vergil Ortiz, one of the biggest names in boxing. He has not one, not two, not three, but four murals in Grand Prairie, Texas. He's very, very popular. He's very talented. 22-0, 21 knockouts. Tremendous amateur career. Tremendous pro career. So it's no surprise that any news about him makes waves, even if it's inaccurate, even if it's not the case, like today. So reporter Michael Benson from England. You know, we're all human. We all make mistakes. And he made a mistake today. He posted the following. Vergil Ortiz versus Duran Boots Ennis and Bam Rodriguez versus Roman Chocolatito are being eyed for possible fight for February 22nd in Riyadh season show in Saudi Arabia. Ortiz and Rodriguez trained Robert Garcia has said. So we'll get in a second to what Robert Garcia has to say about that post. But Rick Meridian, manager to the stars. He has a lot of fighters. Jose Ramirez, Vergil, Misael Rodriguez, and others. He says the following. We are not eyeing Boots. Shuts it down right there. Ortiz, like I said, he's the interim champ at 154. He's WBC interim champ. Ortiz and anyone in the top five works for a big fight. And when an offer comes along, then we will go from there. I think Ortiz / Spence at Cowboy Stadium becomes the biggest fight in Texas history. And Vergil Ortiz Sr. told me the same thing recently, that video where I'm driving with him in the car, in the truck, that Vergil bought for him. He says, so back to Rick. Rick says, Ortiz Spence, Earl Spence Jr., Vergil Ortiz, both in the Dallas area, and it would be a massive fight at Cowboy Stadium, becomes the biggest fight in Texas history. But if someone can afford, Vergil Ortiz Boots Ennis and Vergil Ortiz Terrence Crawford, Rick says, then my phone is on 24/7. All roads lead to Vergil Ortiz for a mega fight in the 154 division. All roads lead to Vergil Ortiz, says Rick Meridian. Crawford's been offered that fight. Crawford has decided to go in other directions. And now he's just waiting for that payday from Canelo. If it's not a payday, then I don't know why would he want to fight Canelo, because it makes no sense. He didn't look too hot at 154. I thought my dream of one. In any event, here's Robert Garcia's response. And Robert says, right off the bat, that's not what the article said. That's not what the article said. I said, if no unification for Bam at 115 is available next for Bam, and if their team, Chocolatito team, won it, because Chocolatito and Bam have a great relationship. Said, if their team wants it, then why not? Bam has a fight November 9 in Philly. And he's fighting his mandatory for Mexico. And he says, it's a good, great fight. You have to tune in. And Robert says, and that's it. Garcia goes on to say, nothing else is being worked on, just speculation. So both Rick Meridian, the manager of Vergil Ortiz, and Robert Garcia shut that post down. Like I said, we're all human. We're all entitled to make mistakes. Life goes on. But Vergil Ortiz is looking to fight anyone and everyone. Spence, Fondora, that guy Bakram, who just fought Tim Zhu. Vergil was actually supposed to fight Tim Zhu a couple months ago. And Tim Zhu, the injury reoccurred his head, and Vergil and his dad were very respectful of Tim Zhu and wished him well, and you know, look forward to that fight happening when it happens. And it's part of boxing. Vergil was supposed to fight Estaniones. Estaniones had an injury. So there's a lot of big fights for Vergil. All the fights will be major, and I can't wait to see what's next for him. And Bam, like I just said, like Robert just said, he's fighting November 9th in Philly, and after that, we will all know more. So stay tuned. We'll see what happens next. But right now, Vergil Ortiz staying in shape. He stays ready, so he doesn't have to get ready. Bam is just 2 weeks and change out from fight night. And it's going to be an exciting, exciting night of boxing when Bam fights. And, of course, when Vergil fights as well. And I mentioned Misael. I don't know if you guys saw this, but there's a video circulating of some guy in a baseball game that gets in an altercation. You see him walking away. I don't think that's Misael. I have to ask him. It doesn't even look like him. But everybody on the internet thinks that's Misael. I got to find the clip and share it with you guys and tell me, do you think that that person is Misael Rodriguez? Let me find that clip right now. Hold on. So here's the clip in question. There's this guy. It's not Misael. Maybe it's his cousin Ezekiel, but it's definitely not Misael Rodriguez. And they're saying the point here, like, real fighters walk away and don't necessarily fight whoever they see. And then they show here Misael hitting the speed bag. I think it's my video right there. It looks like a ES News video. And then you have some highlights of him fighting 14-0, 7 knockouts. And he's supposed to fight, by the way, Misael. He's getting back in the ring November 30th against Omar Chavez, the son of Julio Cesar Chavez Sr. And the first fight ended up in major controversy. They didn't end up fighting. There was some disagreements and some accusations and some nasty words and a whole bunch of drama going down in the locker room. And now they're fighting on November 30th in Mexico. So you would not want to miss that fight. So stay tuned. We'll keep you guys posted. But is that person in that video, is that Misael? No, I don't think so. But you guys tell me, because I've known Misael since he turned pro. No one believed that he was going to win a medal in the Olympics. Just his mom. He made it on his own. And he was the first Mexican to win a medal in a middleweight in, 30, 40 years. I don't know how long. And he's never looked back. And he's very, very popular in Mexico. He was on a show like Survivor. His girlfriend is the number one surfer in the country. So, popularity he has down. So, stay tuned. We'll keep you guys posted for what's going on with everybody. Now, this picture was taken just a couple days ago. I went to Dallas. Vergil was honored in a major football game with tens of thousands, at least 10,000 people on hand. It was the big rivalry between Grand Prairie and Grand Prairie arrival. I think they were called South Grand Prairie, if I'm not mistaken. And Vergil was honored before the fight, and he donated a pair of trunks, a pair of gloves, and a championship belt that Mauricio Suleiman was kind enough to provide to be on display in his high school from now and forever. So we'll keep you guys posted. What is next? There you have it. FearsNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback. And by the way, I don't know about you guys, but Vergil's one of the few fighters that has murals of him as an adult and as a child. He was that much of a prodigy that this mural went up when he was still a kid. And what's so interesting is that across the street from this mural is like the juvenile hall of Grand Prairie, where Vergil Sr. was there as a kid. And he used to look out the window and look at this blank wall. And now his son is with this mural on the wall of his son as a kid. And of course, his son is a boxing star. And it's a historic site. It was recognized, this building as an historic site for Grand Prairie. And with a nice plaque and everything. So boxing fans, you need to appreciate Vergil. Super talented, super nice person. Him and his family. And can't wait to see what's next. Stay tuned. I'm Ellie Secback, Ellie Secback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.